And welcome back to The Morning Blend, where it's time for Ryan J. Reviews.
Ryan is a nationally syndicated film critic and joins us with a go or no-go approach to this weekend's opening films.
That's right.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
So yeah. There's some ones that people are really excited about this week, including the Magic Mike movie that's coming out.
Well, we should all be very excited. This is a movie for the girls and the gays. We're all the target audience here.
It's true. Know?
And,
yes.
And the trailers look great. There's lots of nakedness and muscles and everything. But remarkably, this movie is incredibly unsexy.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know what it is about it. Well, it's directed by Steven Soderbergh, and he won the Oscar for directing Traffic. He did Erin Brockovich, and he tells a great story, and this is a gritty drama starring Channing Tatum, Alex Pettyfer. It's really their story. Mm-hmm. And Channing was a former stripper.
Right. Mm-hmm.
He took his story to Steven Soderbergh based on things he witnessed as a former stripper, and they developed this movie, and he actually steals the show. He's a great dancer. His scenes are like you're watching one of the best hip-hop dancers on So You Think You Can Dance.
Wow.
But everyone else just kind of looks really good. You know, you can open up any magazine and see a hot guy that's got muscles that lives at the gym in an underwear like ad or something. Mm-hmm. But this movie, for some reason, I just really wanted it to be hot. Ahead of the film, I was imagining myself wanting to, you know, reach out into the screen and stuff a single.
Yeah, right.
But I was not inspired during the film.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm surprised because I think he was on the Today Show the other day kind of leading this flash mob dance kind of thing, and it looked really cool, and I thought, oh, I bet that's going to be a good movie. But
he's a great dancer, and it's more just this like drama about dudes who very matter-of-factly happen to be male strippers.
Okay.
So that's not really the reason to go see the movie. If you want to go to get your heart racing, like that's why I wanted to go, it's not going to happen. I feel like we'd do better just going to see. You want to go see Chippendale sometime?
Yeah, right. That would be a little sexier.
Yeah, that might be more fun.
So is this a go or it's a no-go?
It's a go because it is a good film. Soderbergh is a great American director, and it is a gritty drama. So, and how often do we get a male stripper movie, you know?
Yeah.
So,
not enough, maybe?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. If there's one every week, maybe this would be a skip it.
Yeah.
But it's worth seeing for the drama and the story, but it's just not as sexy as you'd expect.
Just a little bit of body. Okay.
Right.
How about Ted? Now, this is I tried getting your opinion out of you last night because I'm very interested in what you think about this by Seth MacFarlane, who writes Family Guy. I love Family Guy. Mm-hmm. I have not been intrigued by it, but many people I know are, even though I love Seth.
This movie is genius.
Is it?
It is brilliant. Oh. It's my favorite comedy since The 40-Year-Old Virgin and the best comedy since Bridesmaids.
No
way.
Yes.
It's rated R,
it's
right?
It's so rated R. This movie is so raunchy and so over the top. And a lot of the times, the things that I find off-putting, like the boy humor, the potty jokes and the farting and the rest of it, didn't annoy me in this movie. I was like rolling on the floor laughing. Thing. It is a hilarious film. And
hilarious.
It's above hilarious. And, you know, basically it comes down to whether or not you like the comedic sensibility of Seth MacFarlane.
Which I do.
If you appreciate TV's Family Guy, you will love this movie as much as I do.
I love Mark Wahlberg. I think he's fantastic.
Brilliant.
I would not picture him in a movie like this, though.
He chooses relatively good scripts. He does a lot of drama. And aside from The Happening, that one M. Night Shyamalan debacle that he made, I really like the movies that he does. And he's great in this. It's Boston's perfect role for him. And Mila Kunis is his love interest. They have great chemistry. And Ted, this movie really hinges on the fact that you have to buy into the suspension of disbelief that this is a living teddy bear. And if you do, it works. And there's a moment in the film towards the end that the whole theater was silent. So obviously it worked. But it's a mix of action and adventure and suspense and fantasy and comedy and just works all across the board. It's brilliant. It's a brilliant movie. I hope it inspires a lot more from Seth MacFarlane.
Okay, yeah, because this is kind of his first big venture into a big screen.
Yeah, it's his
film.
First live action full length.
Yeah.
And you know, we had like the Simpsons movie a few years ago, and it would have been so easy just to do a feature length animated Family Guy, but instead he did this, and I'm so glad for it. It's brilliant.
All right, well, I love him, so I guess I'll give it a try.
Please.
on your
vote. You're going to love it.
People Like Us, what do you think about that?
This is a family drama. The weird thing about this movie is the time of year that it's coming out, right? We've got all these mainstream blockbuster films with 3D and nakedness, and then we've got this quiet family movie. Chris Pine stars as a boy whose father was a bigwig in the music business, who leaves a great sum of money for him after he dies, and he has to give it to the sister he never knew he had, played by Elizabeth Banks. Elizabeth Banks steals the show in this film.
Really?
It's a brilliant dramatic performance from her. I like her usually in comedies, but she really impressed me in this film. She has palpable chemistry with Chris Pine, which creates some great awkward moments because they're brother and sister and can't really go there, but it's not revealed right away.
Because they didn't know each other.
Yeah, so awkward, but good. And Michelle Pfeiffer plays Chris's mom. And if you want a break from the big 3D and the mainstreamness of it all, this is a nice option worth seeing, but it's just kind of not really a summer movie to me.
Mm. Okay, interesting. And you like that cast overall?
I do. I think I always love Michelle Pfeiffer. I'm not a huge fan of Chris Pine. For some reason, he's kind of just interchangeable for me. Mm-hmm. You know, he's not like a Ewan McGregor. He's not the kind of guy I would see a movie just because he's in it. But he's really good in this. Mm-hmm.
Okay, fantastic. So people can find out more, your full reviews, by visiting you online of all the movies currently in theaters. And all you have to do is go to Ryan J. Reviews. There it is on your screen.com, RyanJReviews.com. Good stuff. Thank you, Ryan.
Thank you.
Thank you.